What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to download a Minecraft world. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. When you own a Minecraft server, one of the most important parts is the world. The world holds all of the server's player data, builds, structures, and more. So keeping this world safe is pretty much the owner's biggest task. A great way to make sure you always have a backup of this world is to download it, but because it requires a connection with an FTP, it can cause a lot of confusion, along with knowing which world folder is the correct one. Let's walk through the process of how to do it. Head to the Apex panel and stop your server, and then scroll down to the World Files section and take a note of the name of your world. This is going to be the name of the folder that you want to download. On the left-hand side, click on FTP File Access, and you are going to see some login details that you will use to connect to the FTP. You will need to connect to your server by an FTP program like FileZilla. We have a guide on how to connect using an FTP program that will be linked down below. Once you are connected to that FTP, find the world folder. Keep in mind that the name of the folder will be the exact same as the world field on your main game panel page. Drag the world folder to a separate folder on your computer and wait for it to fully download. Head to the Apex server panel and stop the server. And just like the steps with Java, find the world field and take note of the name. Connect to your files using an FTP program, and once you connect to that FTP, click on the folder named Worlds. In this directory, find the world folder with the same name as the world field and drag it onto your computer. Go to your Apex panel and stop the server and scroll down to find the name of your world just like before. Connect to your server files using an FTP program, and once you're in, find the folder named Pocketmine and go ahead and open it. Once you're there, head to the Worlds directory and then find the world that you want to download and drag it onto your computer. If you added the world to your single player Minecraft, but it's showing a different world than the one on your server, this is most likely because the wrong world was downloaded to your computer. Double check that the world you downloaded has the exact same name as the one in the world field section. It could also mean that the world didn't finish downloading or that it had some corrupted downloads. To fix this, simply re-download it in your FTP program and make sure that there are not any failed transfers. Downloading a world is a great way to make sure you always have a backup saved in the case of anything happening to your server. The downloaded world will only be as updated as the day that you download it, so anytime you make significant changes, it would be a good idea to re-download your server world to your computer. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.